Everybody, soon we will hit the show. I feel the disgusting people in the air. Okay, for those who don't know what's going on, what the hell is going on? Let me give me like 3 minutes. Yeah, Magor just told me don't talk about politics, otherwise I will kick your ass. So, well, Magor was a key member of a movement which was called Second Culture in 70s and 80s, before the Velvet Revolution in 1989 in Czechoslovakia. This term was actually developed by him, and I love that term very much. And it meant pretty much that under totalitarian system, you know, the same one we are living here in the United States, you know, the artists can either participate on the establishment or just say, fuck you, we will create our own culture and we will completely separate from any other, you know, involvement with the main culture. And that's what happened in Second Culture. Yes. So that what happened there, and it was actually so successful that it established a movement which was growing around, you know, around the whole country, and I would call it like sort of a basic initiation or sort of sparking idea and activities which led toward Velvet Revolution. And at the center of that movement was a band which was called Plastic People of the Universe. This band just wanted to play music, they just didn't want to have anything with politics and to be involved with totalitarian system. Yet, the totalitarian system started to panic, because if you don't have a control, like here it's over money, etc., etc., and fear of people to survive, so the establishment starts to panic. So they just put them into the jail. And when they were put to the jail, it actually initiated a charter which was organized by Václav Havel and Jan Patočka, the Czech philosopher, in 1977, and it was called Charter 77. It was pretty much the document which was saying, look, government, you are pretending that there is a freedom of speech, now I am talking about the United States, while you want to jail, for example, Julian Assange, etc. Yeah. So that's a little short political overview. Magore. They don't know about that, you know. So let me explain that a little bit. Okay, so I will shut up. Ivan, while he was in the jail in Valdice, it was the most harsh jail in the country at that time, he wrote a book of poems. And why don't we start with those poems from the jail? I don't know why it's making that noise, but that's fine. Who cares?
You can talk without mic.
And it's better with the mic. Can you hold me the light, please?
Proto, že to znám od výslechu, to svícení do očí, že to nepotřebuju tady.
He wanted to say that he knows it from the interrogations.
He memorized it probably.
Can somebody hold me a light? Thank you. First I'm blind, and I am very sick today. The guard dog's howl continues as Radim celebrates the Eucharist. The words to the song, oh, Saint Michael, ascend from the cell. The chalice is a spoon and the host of a roll. The Lord God is with us forevermore.
Služební psi na dvoře ví, Radim slaví Eucharistii. Slova písně o svatý Michaeli plynou se z cely. Kalichy lžíce a hostie jsou zveky. Pán Bůh je s námi po všechny věky.
If you could turn off the sounds.
God, do you know at all about me? Since you have shut me up in here, do you ever remember me in this filthy pit for years? You made laurels and night shade, which will end my days. Have you condemned me to useless fame? Or will I die somewhere in shame? I beg you humbly, Lord Bartholomew, so cruelly flayed. Do not leave me anymore in the Leviathan's mouth in vain.
Víš ty, Bože, vůbec o mně? Že jsi mě zavřel v tomhle domě. Odsoudil jsi mě k věčné slávě, nebo pojdu v hnojné jámě. Stvořil jsi vavříny i u něj. Co z toho jsi schystal pro mě? Odsoudil jsi mě k marné slávě, nebo pojdu někde v slávu? Z kůží v ruce Bartoloměj, pokorně tě prosím, pane. Už mě nenech vězet marně v Leviatanově plavě.
On the facade, Cygnus olor, inside terror and horror. From the other side, St. Bruno guards terrifying depth of dark. Gutted like a pig, the church gleams at the clink.
na průčelí Cygnus Olor, uvnitř hrůza je auror. Z druhé strany svatý Bruno stráží děsuplné luno. Vykuchaný jako prase, stkví se tady kostel baset.
In misfortune I always return deftly to a religion, but I don't even pray anymore as soon as I settle in. The saints in niches on the facade should perhaps intercede with Saint Hugo, with the Swan. Only you can forgive me. 22 angels on the floor above are stuck to pilasters in a line 10-20 years in the joint. In miserable bits, men serve out their time. They sit around me in the church. On their faces are shadows cast, not by the eternal lamp, by natural gods. God is, it is just midday. Or do I discern the approach of night? Is the bomb like a big knife? Is the wind tearing out the last leaves from the hawthorn in the yard? Or will they again grow green? Tell me, is there bark around the sky as around the trees on earth? Or do only angels course surround you in your glory? Is that you, God, in that void? Is that void, does there burn fire? Sultry, south frosty north, in Kartosi, the navel of the world, as the neck of a swan, who bends me, you Lord? The presbytery has no altar. From the burn come hell's flames. In misfortune I always pray with the gentle patter of the rain on the stony faces of the saints.
Neštěstí se vždycky hbitě vracím k religiozitě, jak se však trochu zabydlím, už se zas ani nemodlím. Přimluvit by se snad měli svědci v nikách na průčelí se svatým Hugem Savským. Odpustit můžeš mi jen ty. Patře nade mnou 22 andělů, přilepilo se na pilastry. 10 let, 20 v údělu lidi zde mají hrozné fastry. Sedí v kostele kolem mě, ne věčná lampa, zemní plyn na jejich tváře vrhá stín. Bože, je teprv poledne, nebo pat na svět celou mrak už. Je bomba jenom velký nůž? Poslední listí vítr rve na dvoře z hlavů? Nebo se zazelenají poznovu? Řekni mi, je oheň v srdci prázdnoty? Jsi v prázdnotě to, pane, ty? Je kolem nebes taky kůra jako na strmech na zemi? Nebo jen kůry andělské obklopují tě slávě tvé? Mrazivý sever horkých je pupek světa v kartouzích. Bez oltáře presbytář, od hořáků jde pekla zář. Modlím se vždycky v neštěstí, kamenným světcům po tvářích, jemný déšť, jemně šelest.
Mount Saint Michel is great. The farthest I've come is Balditze. My poems are all cliches, and herpes marks my face.
Krásná hora Mont Saint Michel, já nejdál do Balditze jsem přišel. Moje básně jsou samý kliše, na hubě vyrazil mi lišej.
It's hard to compose elegies when everyone's sucking penises. How inadequate every rhyme is to describe them sucking privates. So as not to sound like a hooligan, I write down only now and then how one prisoner pleasures another convict's genitals.
Těžko se píšou elegie, když kolem cucají si pije, a každý rým je na to chudý popsat, jak kouří si zde údy. Abych zas nepsal výtržnicky, zaznamenám jen sporadicky, jak jeden odsouzený přelíz druhému zločincovi penis.
In Vienna, Vrátě waits for the coming autumn days. A dry wind blows from the barren plains. This year in Vysočina I see they are harvesting flags without me.
Pardon, Vysočina is Highland.
Highland, way out here in Valdice, I sit perhaps so as to see a little bit more of the bottomless pit. No longer will I drink beer with Vrátě. I remain here. You will sleep along far away beyond I glow, oh, beyond I glow. At the table you'll sit along, as from a fan a light breeze will blow and stir the surface of your bowl. The last breath of wind from the barren plains blowing from the south at midday. Through Znojmo it's just a short way, and farther on for me you'll wave. In that old Celtic land you will stay. In Vienna, just a short way, Miss Marie Vrátě is drinking beer. Through Znojmo it's just a short way from here.
Se na mě zase musím podívat. I must look it because I don't remember.
A teď potřebuje
světlo.
Potřebuje
světlo. No light. Vrátě vyhlíží ve Vídni blížící se dne podzimní, vane na Vídeň z pusty fén, na Vysočině letos len sklízou beze mě. Snad abych z jámy beze dne poznal zas o pár sáhů víc, za Pařescem až do Válnic. Nebudu svrátu pít už mrtu, zůstal jsem tu. Ty budeš sama spát v dálce tam za iglau, au, za iglau. Poledne budeš sedět u talíře, lehonký vánek, jako od vějíře, trochu zatřese hladinou. To z jihu vratry zavarou, odrazy větru spusty fén. Přes Nojmo je to kousek jen. A budeš na mě čekat dál v té staré zemi Keltů. Ve Vídni kousek podál s Marií vráťa pije Meltu. Přes Nojmo je to kousek jen.
Mountain bound in corn bin, river Terry is crying, fields encircled by headlands, Christ rising in anguish, sheaf tied with ligatures, grave filled in this earth, candles pierced by flames, hearts cruelly tied, lips with bitterness closed, cold gnawed into the bones, churches stacked with a cross, or in a cloud swathed, and eyes wide with shock at it all, read the burning inscription in the wall.
Hora svačcem omotaná, řeka pláčem naplakaná, pole souvrať obepíná, na mukách se Kristus vzpíná. Snop povřísle převázený, hrob hrůdami zaházený. Svíce plameny protknuté, srdce stírané ukrutně. Ústa sevřená trpkostí, mráz zahryznutý do kostí. Kostely křížem probodené, nebe oblakem zahalené a oči hrůzou vytřeštěné, hořící nápis před čtou stěně.
They go to vote on the way from prayer, and from elections they go straight to church. So what did Zion rise up for there? And what good did Mount Horeb serve? Oh, Saint John Hus, Christianity, what a disgust!
Jdou volit cestou z kostela, na mši jdou přímo z voleb. Nač tady potom Sion stál a k čemu hora Oreb? Ach, svatý Jane Husi, jak se mi křesťanstvo hnusí. Já ne, já bych tu poslední nechal.
Jo?
Jo? Tak
se
a ty další já bych rovnou dal.
To je na tobě,
Ivan. Ne, že už bych s tebou končil.
Dobře, tak pustí postavit.
Tak that's all. I very thank you for our patience.
Before we see some documents from the Czech underground and plastic people of the universe, I just brought you the original of this book of poems which Ivan Magor wrote in Valdice prison. It happened that I owe it from the Czech underground. It's the complete original. You can see it was done in samizdat. Yeah. So it looks exactly like your junk mail hitting your, you know, mail every day. And so it was done at all. Why don't I send it along the whole thing? Please don't remove any pages. Just you can touch it and then return it to me. Yeah? Thank you.
So now I would like to show you the old documentary from the early 70s, from 74, and it's footage from one of underground festivals who were managed by Magor heroes. And this footage was taken by the secret police during the court with plastic people, and they use it for propaganda purposes.
So I'm now she can't continue. Oh, že vidoucí volové víc uvidějí smrtí smrtci.
Thank you.
there will be a short intermission, like 10 minutes, and the musicians will set their, you know, gear, and they will be playing, you know, while we will be watching all underground films, yeah? So, take 10 minutes. And where is my book of music of Ivan Magoriev?
Thank you. listening to Ivan Birmanzo, original member of Plastic People, and people from Boston here, you know, from Berklee College, whose name I don't know. except Tom Plšek, yeah, and Mirek Kočandro, who is here, they are his students, you know, so he organized them to come.
Originally Czech. Yeah. Can I say, please, že to znělo jako plastici za mladá.
Yeah, it sounded like plastics when they were young. So hopefully there will be also a revolution!
Guys, what are your names?
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.